I don't really have hair.
You don't really have hair?
No.
No, yeah.
This is fun.
How's that?
I'm so happy. Should I sit here?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so excited. Hi everyone, it's Jackie, and today I've got Rachel.
Hi, I'm Rachel. Nice to meet you all. Been a makeup artist for around about 10 years now.
So. 10 years?
Yeah, a long time.
Oh, really? Wow.
I know, it's a long, long time.
Yeah.
So I do mainly weddings, so that's what I specialise in.
Yes. All right, so today I want to find out new look.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely. Quite a full coverage, dewy finish.
Yeah.
And then we were just speaking about tones, weren't we, for colour wise.
Yes.
And these are nice, these are like sunset colours.
Yeah, like orange.
Yeah.
Can I show?
Yeah, of course. This is the Urban Decay
cute.
Makeup.
Wow. I love orange.
So what we're going to start with then is just prepping the face.
Yeah.
So have you got any makeup on or anything at the moment?
No, not at all. So I've got just a cream on that.
Just creams on, lovely. Okay, can I clip your hair back? Yeah. Is that okay? Just to keep it out of the way. The lovely hair. Lovely long hair.
Thick.
Oh, it's really nice. So what kind of skin type have you got?
Do
you
dry.
Go quite dry,
very
yeah?
Very dry.
Okay. So I've just used some Clarins cleanser. This is great for like a drier skin type. So I'm just going to just use some cotton pads just to gently wipe over the skin.
Is it a toner?
It's like a cleanser and toner
cleanser.
In one. So it's nice and quick and easy to use.
Mm-hmm.
We all want to save time in the morning, don't we?
Yeah. So instead of washing your face, do
you
use
can
this
use
or
this.
After washing your face?
Or you could use this to get the majority of your makeup off.
Yeah.
And then use like a face wash after if you wanted to. Some people
yeah.
just prefer to have water used on their face
yeah.
as a cleanser. So you could
mm-hmm.
do like, you know, both of them together. Okay, so then what I'm going to put on now is a moisturiser. This is a Bobbi Brown day cream. This smells lovely.
Oh,
isn't it
orange.
So nice? Yes, it's got lovely ingredients in here. So this is just going to soothe the skin
mm-hmm.
and give a really nice base for the makeup.
How do you find out the best product?
Trial
like
and
you,
error. A lot of reviews. Yeah, try them out on myself, friends, and look at reviews as well.
Mm-hmm.
What's popular at the moment? So Bobbi
yeah.
Brown's really good. Charlotte
mm-hmm.
Tilbury do some nice creams as well. Mm-hmm. How does that feel?
Yeah, good.
Great, okay. So we're just gonna leave that to soak in. And what we're going to do now is just jump straight to eye makeup. Okay, so I'm gonna use an eye primer.
Mm-hmm.
So I've got a couple here. We can either use the MAC one, which has kind of got a little bit of a pinky tone to it, which
colour.
Is quite nice. Yeah, it does go quite light on the skin though.
Yeah.
And then we've got this Urban Decay one here.
Mm-hmm.
So I think I might go for this one because it's
yeah, sure.
more of a yellowy undertone,
yeah.
which will
Did
suit
you
your
like
skin
it?
Type. Can you see that's quite pink
yeah.
for your skin type?
Mm-hmm.
I'll go for
so
this one.
So you have to choose the close colour to
yes,
your
absolutely.
Skin.
Yeah.
yeah.
Louise, do you want to close your eyes for me? So you've got some tattoo makeup on already, haven't you? So I'm just going to be careful not to go over that because we don't want to.
You can go over.
Okay, is that what you normally do? And then you then draw over on
yeah.
top of it. Okay, get you.
Mm-hmm.
It will neutralise the eyelids, but also create something for your shadows to kind of adhere to stick
mm-hmm.
to.
So it's better to put primer first all
on
the time.
First, yeah, all the time. Yeah, definitely. What we're going to look for first is a transition colour, so something that's quite matte. So you want some colours like these ones here, or some of the lighter tones here.
Yeah.
Okay, just close your eyes for me. Can we talk during these sorts of things?
Yeah.
Can we just edit everything out?
Yeah. And we're going
to...
You don't have to put powder on after you...
No, because it kind of dries as a powder. I'm using a blending brush for this, because you just want it to be seamless. You don't want any harsh lines or harsh edges.
Mm-hmm.
So this blending brush will just keep those to a minimum. So I'm using that little circular movement. Can I just open up for me? Lovely. And then you can get a clean blending brush and then just get rid of any excess. Can't really see it, but when we use extra shadows, they're gonna blend in really well. Lovely, have you got a little mirror here?
Wow.
Yeah?
That's so nice.
Yeah, looks lovely on you, doesn't it?
Very natural colour.
Yeah, but it's there, isn't it? We can then build up on that. Yeah, it does, it looks lovely.
Wow, amazing. What colour did you use?
This was just this sort of colour, so you can get those from anywhere. You know, it's like,
mm-hmm.
as long as it's matte.
Yeah.
You want a matte shade. You don't want any shimmers. It won't get that effect.
Yeah.
It just needs to be matte.
Okay.
So we'll pop a little bit more just on the X one.
Yeah.
I'm kind of just going where the crease is of the eye, so just here, where you can form like the eyelid. Again, just going in with circular movement. I'm using quite light pressure, aren't I? I'm not, you know, not firm. So what's going on with the wedding then? Is it three times, did you say?
It's yeah. So we cancelled three times and we are going to have it this summer, but I think we have to cancel it.
Why, is that where you were going, Japan?
Yes, we're going to have it in Japan.
Okay, so we've gone in with those. If you want to have a look at those two, so that's the transition colour applied.
Yeah, whoa.
So you could easily wear that, just that colour with mascara and everything else as a day look. If we just keep it natural, we can just go with a little bit more depth. So, a small amount to begin with. Can you see I'm just applying just on this outer corner here? And we'll blend it out again. So can you see I'm always applying and then blending?
Yeah, with different brush.
Yeah, with a different brush.
Right.
It has to be like quite a clean brush. Is that the cat scratching?
Yeah.
I bet they come. Do they come a lot in your videos? Do they?
Yeah.
So it's just to the outer corners.
Before you become a makeup artist, how long did you practice a day?
So I'm a makeup artist and beauty therapist. So I went to college for 2 years and then went on makeup courses as well.
All right.
Just to kind of upskill and keep current. And then yeah, went self-employed.
So you travel around?
Yes.
Do you think you will have a salon at your place sometime?
I'm not sure. I quite like keeping to bridals and travelling around. Nice to go see all the you know, the venues where the weddings are held, the lovely beautiful places.
Yes.
Lovely. Let's have a little look at that. What do we think so far?
Oh, really nice.
The brown.
Oh, the brown. Very dark, isn't it?
Yeah. But when you blend it out, it softens it. So it looks dark and then you'll blend it and soften it.
Fluffy.
No, you go for it. Do as many as you want, that's fine. Blend just with a fluffy brush just to get rid of. So once we've done the eyeshadow, what I'm going to do now is just tidy away underneath the eye area. You can use a face wipe. Oh my day, she made me jump. I thought it was someone. Hi. It was Nick. So just underneath the eye area, so can you see we've got fallout? So if I'd done your concealer, I'd have had to have gone over that again. So it just kind of saves time. Right, so let's look at base now. So you said you wanted quite a dewy finish, didn't you? So a lovely primer that we can use is Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Flawless Filter. Okay, so we're just going to pop a little bit of this on, just to apply just to where we want like a bit of highlight, so on cheekbones. So I'm just going to apply this mattifying product, which is just going to go on across the nose area just to prevent any excess oiliness. This is just going to go just on. Tests colours, if that's okay, so bear with me. Just to make sure we've got the right colour. So I think what I'm going to do is use two foundations. I'm going to use the MAC one, Studio Fix, and then a Makeup Forever just to top up if needed.
Is it a foundation?
It is, yes. Just so we can get that full coverage. So I'm stippling it onto the skin, and then I can buff out. This one's from Zoeva. Yeah, stippling brush. Stippling just means like patting on. And then blend out after. I was going to go over this with a black coal first, with on the eyeliner, just to just outline that shape. So you just want to close your eyes for me. Thank you. So even that, with just with a pencil, looks nice. It's like quite a softer look. And then if you wanted to, because we've done a pencil, we could always then smoke that liner out just a little bit. You know, gels are great, gel liners or liquid liners. If you just wanted maybe a more of a natural or softer look, pencils are fab too. You could always just maybe set with a powder. We could go over with the powder on this just to make sure it's set.
Oh, after eyeliner.
After eyeliner, yeah.
Okay.
So once I've done that, what I'll do is I'll go with a darker colour. Okay, so I've just gone over with a little bit of powder. It was eyeshadow. So it was like a black eyeshadow just to kind of set it.
You don't use setting powder?
No, not for the, because It might just mute the tone of the black. Yeah. You want obviously it to be black.
So powder eyeshadow.
With a with an eyeshadow. Eyeshadow powder just to set. Mm-hmm. Let's have a little look, fam. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is do the waterline at the top. Have you ever done that before? Tight lining.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm going to use is a waterproof eyeliner. Just look down, like look over here for me. That's it. So I'm just going to pick up the eye, look down a little bit more. That's it. And just pick up the eye. Fab, so if you look in the mirror now, you can see. Ooh. Looks fab. What we're going to have a little look at now is we'll do like brows and then we'll look at like mascara underneath the eye area and do things like that. So do you want me to do just my sort of thing with brows?
Yes. I'll leave it to you.
Okay.
So you decide the shape.
Yeah. It's always a good idea just to like brush through the brows first.
I don't really have hair.
You don't really have hair?
No.
Oh yeah. That's fine, we'll brush through anyway.
This is a funny thing, like since I was a kid, I don't have much hair on my eyebrows.
Yeah, you've got a little bit here, but it just kind of goes a little
fade
bit
away.
Yeah, yeah.
This is fun.
It's great, isn't it? So what I've used now is an eyebrow pomade.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's from Inglot, and it basically makes things waterproof. And also it brings things back to life. So if your mascara was really dry, and it was your favourite mascara, you could add a little bit of this to it to kind of bring it back.
Where did you get it?
It's from Inglot, it's called Duraline.
Only £10?
Yeah.
Oh, that's different shape that I normally draw.
Do you like it or is it a bit too dark?
No, it's fine. I like it. So you made a little bit arch?
Yeah, it's got an arch in there.
Mm.
It's funny because I don't know what you normally do. Yeah. I can't remember, so it's I'm doing like my own little thing here. So have you had them microbladed?
This is also a tattoo, same as the eyeliner.
Right,
I got it 10 years ago.
Microblading, isn't it?
Microblading,
yeah. It doesn't come off. No, it's like semi-permanent makeup.
Do you have it?
No.
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 Because you want to change the shape?
Well, mine are quite thick anyway.
Oh, right. Like you.
Look.
Oh, nice. This is like totally opposite.
Is that
what I do normally?
Oh, goodness.
Yeah. No, I like it. Okay. I like it.
Okay.
But today I want to find out new makeup.
So we've put those on.
Yeah.
We're going to look back at base now. So we've got some concealers and things to put on as well. So I've got some different concealers here. Again, I've got some Urban Decay ones and Tarte ones are quite good. Just look up for me. It was 22N light neutral.
So this is good for full coverage?
Yeah, for underneath the eyes, for concealer, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm going to just pop on is a little bit of contour. So I'm going to go back to that palette that we've gone through. So I'm just going to have a little play with just a bit of contour. Just to kind of blend up.
Yeah.
I'm going to do it to the opposite side. So it's just basically on your cheekbone.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so once we've done that, we can then obviously pop some powder on just to mattify the areas that we need to.
Yeah.
So you don't want to go everywhere with a powder.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you want to go, because if you want a dewy finish,
yeah.
You want it underneath the eye area,
mm-hmm.
around the nasolabial folds,
yeah.
and maybe just on the nose.
Right, so you don't put around the hair?
No.
So
I'll go underneath the eye,
mm-hmm.
just around here, the nose, maybe a little bit on the, like the top lip and into the forehead a little bit. But you want all of this to stay dewy. So just before we do that, I'm just gonna go back to the Charlotte Tilbury. This was the primer that we used, but you can use it as a highlighter. So I'm just gonna pop some back on just over the top here. And this is Laura Mercier setting powder.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just gonna be, it's lovely, yeah. It's brilliant for all skin tones.
Oh, nice.
It's a pinky colour, it's from it's actually
pink.
Okay, so You just want to look just down here for me. Does that feel okay? Is that okay?
Mm-hmm.
So we'll go back in with the transition colour just to go underneath the eye areas. You want to look up for me. That's really nice. I'm just going to go just on the lash line. Blend out again, just lovely. For the cheekbone, we've got this MAC, it's soft and gentle on the cheekbones just here. Highlight there, we can pop some over the Cupid's bow.
Or the same.
That same shade, only a small amount. So we'll go in with a liner first. This is just a Kiko liner.
Really nice.
It's lovely, isn't it? Lovely. What do we think of that?
Finished?
Yeah.
Nice. Oh wow. I shouldn't cut my front hair. I cut yesterday. It's too short, isn't it? Look.
Did you cut it yourself?
こんな感じになりました。ちょっとねナチュラルルックにしたくて、はい、オーダーしたんですけど、目はねオレンジを使ってます。オレンジとかちょっとね茶色系を使って、ちょっとね反射してさ唇の色がちょっと見えないけど淡いオレンジです。
It's just spritz with a fix spray. This is in the Urban Decay All Night. So if you just want to take a deep breath inClose your mouth, exhale. There we go.
So you put the concealer a little bit lighter here.
Yes, a little bit lighter underneath the eye area. You always want a shade or two lighter than your natural skin tone. To make them a little bit more darker. So if we get like... So close your eyes for me. More blend it.
What kind of makeup is trending now in the UK?
Definitely for brow wise, everyone's wanting fluffy brows, aren't they? Don't know if you've seen brow lamination.
What kind of a shape? Like arty?
Yeah, like absolutely. That. Similar shape to this. And then if you've got like thicker hair, it'd be good to just to brush them upwards, depending on obviously your very natural hair. I've added a little bit of.Warmth to that eye.
Oh, that's nice. Did you put on this side?
Not yet, just on this one.
That's nice. I like it.
We'll do on this one. Yeah, and then that can then always come just underneath a little bit if you wanted to. Yes, it's up to you. You've got control of how dark you want to go.
Yeah.
As long as you just keep blending. Yeah.
So you just use the matte eyeshadow.
You just use matte today, yeah.
If you want to use this kind of...
Yeah.
Texture, how do you use
it? Yeah, so I'll probably use that in the middle of your lid. Which colour would you prefer to use? Do you know that one?
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah. So you can take a photo with them both. So you've got one that's more, so we've got more of an eveningy look and then more of a natural.
There we go.
It's lovely, isn't it?
This is very pretty.
Yeah, it's gorgeous.And then because we've got a bit darker with your makeup, now we can add like a bit more depth to like your bronzer or your cheeks. We could always go in with more if we wanted to.
I really like this.
It looks gorgeous.
Really like this.
You can add black in with your dark brown to add a bit of contour, but you don't just want it on its own. I think the sunset sort of colour is really lovely on you.
Okay.
How's that?
I'm so happy. Sure. Skin looks really nice. I mean, highlight.
Yeah, it's radiant, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's all seamless, isn't it? All blends from one to another. We just don't want any harsh lines. That's what we want to avoid.
Because you always blend.
Yeah, in circular motions. Yeah, keep blending.
Circular motion.
You can pat on and then circular motions.
I see.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll try that.
No problem.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Rachel.
Thank you. Oh, Shaggy, you look gorgeous.
Yes,
you do.
Rachel is cleaning.
I know.
I really like this look.
Hello.
Rachel looks like this. beautiful lady.
Oh, thank you. Hi.
So I have to get all the products you use today. Thank you so much.
No problem. Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching.
Bye.
はい、っていう感じでナチュラルライトで見るとこんな感じになります。あの最後はね、濃くしてもらいました。ここに結構あの濃いブラウン入れたり、ちょっとチークを強くしたり。どうだろう、なんかいつも私がするさメイクと違うね。全然違う。海外で涙袋を描く方は見ないんですよ。そう、お友達も結構ガッと黒いライナー描いたりとかブラウン使ったりするので、はい、こういうメイクになってます。はい、ということで今日はちょっと違った感じで、はい、メイクしてもらいました。
What color normally do you use for bride?
Like for bridals, they love this sort of color. You know these. So this is like a lovely bridal palette.
So
you've got all your dusky pinks, and then you could always add like browns. Maybe that one's purple, so maybe not the purple, but maybe a darker brown. That's lovely. Complements them really well. Nice rosy like pink cheeks or soft peach on the cheeks. They just want to be dewy, radiant, but they want makeup that lasts.
Yeah.
So that's why something like the fixing spray that we used would be perfect, because it just holds it into place.
I see. Next time I have to ask you to do bride.
A bridal look.
Yeah.
We're all feeling a bit nervous already. Every time I'm down here, you make me smile. You're the solution.